Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. I am Dr. Muhammad Mehtab Alam and I am discussing about non-parametric test. This is the output generated from the computer. So run test for cola. Run test for cola, run above and below k is equal to 0.692308 and the observed in number of runs is equal to 12 while the expected number of run is 12.0769. 18 observation above K and 8 below K. N is a small, so the following approximation may be invalid. P value is equal to 0.971. Now, how you can do the run test for large sample? Consider the following manufacturing example. A machine produces parts that are occasionally flawed when the machine is working in adjustment, flaw still occur between but seem to happen randomly. A quality control person randomly select 50 of the part produced by the machine today and examine them one at a time in order that they were made. The results is 40 parts with no flaws and 10 parts with flaws. The sequence of no flaws denoted by N and flaws denoted by F is shown in an upcoming slides. Using alpha 0.05, the quality controller tests to determine whether the machine is producing randomly, the flaw are occurring randomly or not. If either N1 or N2 is greater than 20, the sampling distribution of R is approximately normal. This is the decision rule. So here, this is the formula you can apply to calculate the value, and this is the Z formula, and this is the formula for a standard deviation. This is formula for mean randomness for mean, randomness for a standard deviation, and this is formula to calculate Z value. Now here, the null hypothesis will be the observation in the sample are randomly generated. And the alternate hypothesis will be the observation in the sample are not randomly generated. And significance level is given type 1 error rate 0.05. So N1 is equal to 40, it is also given, and N2 is equal to 10. If minus 1.96 is less than or equal to Z or less than and equal to 1.96, do not reject null hypothesis, otherwise reject it. So calculate on the formula, calculate this, and R is equal to 13.